For 12 years, the Olympic movement has been going forward at pace. But here in Buenos Aires, its future direction will today be determined. One of Jack Rogge's last acts as IOC president was this here on Saturday.
Tokyo! Yeah!
After two terms at the helm, the Belgian now steps down. So how does he think he's done?
I think that people would recognize that under my watch there were very good Olympic Games. The creation of the Youth Olympic Games, the renewed fight against doping and illegal betting, the funding of sport through a very healthy revenue. So I think that's going to be the legacy.
On the all-male shortlist to replace him is legendary Ukrainian pole vaulter Sergey Bubka, IOC finance chief Richard Carrion, Sir Miang from Singapore, former Olympic rower Denis Oswald, and boxing administrator Ching-Kuo. But the front runner is IOC vice president German Thomas Bach.
I think it would become clear that the IOC is a sports-oriented organization. Showing that the raison d'etre of the IOC is sport and the Olympic Games and its values. This is, one of the main items of my program.
A man tipped to be a future president is London 2012 chief Lord Coe, and he thinks the fight against doping must now be a priority.
It's the global challenge. There's not a country that's immune from this problem. You know, we've all had our moments, and as international federations, we have to maintain, you know, this is a war. It's not a war that we can lose, and we have to make sure that the one thing that shines through is trust.
The IOC and its members often find themselves the subject of protests, and these last few days have been no exception. The controversy surrounding the next Winter Olympics in Sochi next year and the Rio Summer Games in 2016 mean that the most powerful figure in sport might just need to be the most diplomatic too. Dan Roan, BBC News, Buenos Aires.